What's up, you guys? It's been a little minute since I've been on here. I love this channel because we dive in deeper to planning stuff, and between us, you might feel the same. I've been kind of struggling with keeping up with reading lately, and it's a habit that I really enjoy that just makes me happier as a human being. And I've been stuck on the same book looking at my Kindle for like a month now. So it's time to move on. This is the book that I'm stuck on. It's the second one in a series. I think the reasoning being, there's nothing wrong with it, it's just really long. It's like a 17-hour audiobook, to give you an idea of how big of a book it is. I'm gonna set up the reading tracker. So you might have seen me do a plan with me back in the day where I actually like drew out a bookshelf with like plants and stuff on it. It took me forever. We decided to launch inserts for tracking your reading, challenges for reading, and kind of just inspire you to get back into reading. They all lived happily ever after. So I'll take you through this. I'm gonna set up my own planner right now. I was gonna do a dedicated reading tracker with one of the luxe covers. So I was gonna do the beige one with maybe like rose gold, because I feel like it kind of matched the theme of this, which I thought was kind of cute, right? Do we like the coloring? Like, I feel like that's cute. Or because my theme of book is like a dark soul, I really love like a good mystery thriller crazy lady book. So I was gonna do the black one with the black discs, or I'm gonna take apart Audrey's planner. This is his with, he does like the lined paper. We're not gonna do that. We're not gonna do that. That would just be mean. So I don't know, I'm kind of torn right now. I have some dividers too, so I was kind of gonna categorize stuff and then label them. So let's talk books. I'll just be super honest. I'm kind of over the whole like motivation, rah, rah, rah style book. I feel like I kind of overdid it for a while, did like 10 years of that. If that's your jam, go for it. I think that my version right now, other than fiction, which I'm all about that life, I'll give you some of my top picks as well as what's on my reading list. So my top books of all time, I get asked this a lot, fiction wise, and then I'll give you some motivation stuff. I have some here. I love a Kindle. I'm a Kindle gal. I've been converted. I would say my top books ever, top three, Verity, The Housemaid, and The Perfect Marriage. So Verity is Colleen Hoover. There's three Housemaid books, by the way. Make sure you read them in order if you read them. They're so good. The third one is coming out this summer and I'm like ready for it. Housemaid is by Frieda McFadden. Love her other books too. And then The Perfect Marriage is Geneva Rose. I read another Geneva Rose. I read another one called You Shouldn't Have Come Here, and I really did not love it. But The Perfect Marriage, so, so good. So I'm gonna set this up. I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit about like the other books that I have here and just stuff that I wanna kinda add to my list. I would love your suggestions on what you think that I should be reading next and what you're gonna be reading next. I put on my TBR, which I'm gonna fill out right now, The Housemaid is Watching, so that one's coming out this summer, so I mean, it'll be on my TBR, but I can't read it yet. The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, I just keep hearing that I need to read it. And then Too Late by Colleen Hoover. I have no context, it's just what is suggested. So I usually go on my Kindle, and then there is Popular This Month, Amazon Original Books For You. So Goodreads is a website that you can go on and basically say if you liked a certain book, you can add to your list too, but it'll say like, if you like a certain book, this is what they would suggest, which I very much love. Oh, The Wife Upstairs by Frieda McFadden was very good too. Never Lie by Frieda McFadden was also very good. And I know everybody always tells me to read The Silent Patient because I loved Verity. The Silent Patient was ruined for me by a lovely lady on the Disney cruise that wanted to explain to me how great the book is, as well as certain chapters. Thank you, lady on the Disney cruise. I'm so sensitive to spoilers. Let's dive into it. So I'm gonna remove the cover. So I'm gonna try and do a balance for my reading tracker slash lists of a balance between fiction, a little bit more heavy on the fiction because I just wanna focus more on like me time and less pressure of doing better. There's like the table of contents and the guides for this just at the beginning. So you can remove those. You don't have to have them in there. You can as a reminder. It just kind of explains how to use the trackers as well as the challenges. So there's three bookshelf sheets, front and back, that you can write the covers, you can color in the spines, you can add some little doodles, and then there's a blank shelf if you wanna draw your own. I put those three in. I really like the one that's like you flip horizontal. Dividers. This is actually perfect. A new era of me. They're like a bendy plastic divider with a pretty gold foil on them. I love them. And then you can use the tabs to label it. And there's so many freaking labels on these that there's always something that works. Yeah, books. And each label has two fonts of everything. So there's like the capital letter one, and then there's the cursive one. So it's completely up to you. So I'm gonna label that. Prompt. This is what I need. This is literally what I need. If you're struggling right now to be motivated to read, this is what you need. There's space to create your own challenge, or you can use our challenge. It's basically a prompt. So I'll give you the example of like the top one has a city on the cover. And there's another one that like has an animal on the cover, is under 200 pages. So it can kind of just help you pick a book, which half of the battle is sometimes that. Or you can create your own challenge. So I'm gonna put both of these in here and I'm gonna add a new divider. Daily Grind team did a freaking good job on this. There is a sticker called Challenges. Small steps daily that also fits perfectly. So this is a 4-month system, meant to go with our 4-month system of the planner. So you have a 4-month TBR, and this, what you can do is either write the cover, draw the cover, write the title, or what I'm gonna try and do is I have one of these like cute printers. I have one at home in Canada, but I bought one here. And you can actually do like a little printout of the cover if you want. So basically you have your 4-month layout and then you have each month with a priority read at the bottom. I need this. I need this in my life. So we have 4 of these because 4 months, love that journey. So then I'm gonna do another divider. I'm gonna put these in here. Yeah, this is perfect. So I'm gonna use this as my 3rd tab. And I'm gonna grab the sticker for the label, like the label that says, I think there's one that says monthly or this month. Yeah. So I'm going to add in the 4-month reading wrap up and like what I thought. So you can like put how many stars, like how much you like what you rate it as. So I'm gonna put that under the monthly. So there's a monthly reading wrap up and then there's a 4-month reading wrap up. And this is gonna be my little, I'm gonna call this my little reading nook book, and then weekly reading log. So there is 4 months worth in here, and I'm going to put in my 4th tab, and I'm gonna put the label that I'm gonna use is this week. And then the other option obviously is just insert this right with your regular daily planner, either at the back or like store the pages that you don't really need. That's something I do at home. I will just get like a little folder and put whatever I'm not using in the folder, and then I'll add it as I go. All right, so I am going to file these away. I'm not gonna toss them, I'm gonna keep them. They're just like the explanation of each page, and then as well as the covers. I'm just gonna keep that. Ooh, this could be perfect. The washi tape from the Luxe Collection, gold and rose gold. Yes, honey. So in terms of nonfiction, I'm really trying to go easy on myself. I do have this book that I got as a gift at Christmas. I'm interested, but I'm in a place right now where I feel like if I overdo with like the motivation books, it literally burns me out. I don't know how else to explain it. It's like, you're doing too much. I love a good workbook. I'm literally writing a workbook right now, the next one. But this workbook is our main workbook, and it's our first ever 200 pages of just pure actionable goals. Like if you are lost in life and you don't know what the heck you want, you need help getting motivation, time management, boundaries, like that is it. Cause it'll just set you on the right track for life. That to me is my type of motivation where I can actually like put it into writing and do something about it. Not just hearing someone tell me to be better. It's like a sensitivity that I have. I think I just overdid it on the personal development for too many years. And it was like ingrained into me. I think right now between workbook, and I go through the Dreamlike Blueprint myself, I go through it about every 4 months or less. Like I'm due to do it, like I'm ready to do it. I feel it. Every 4 months I'm like, I wanna do it again. And then in terms of nonfiction, I would say biographies. I really wanna read this one. And then health books. So I bought this one. It's by the same people that wrote Wheat Belly, or person, William Davis. So super gut. And then I love these ones, Medical Medium. So I mean, it would be quite the book to make my way through, but I'm more motivated and interested in those that are nonfiction, but I just wanna lean towards the fiction books. It just makes me the happiest. So like I said, I'm in a reading rut right now. I'm stuck on this book, we're switching it up. I'm gonna go into my Kindle app and pick something that is in Kindle Unlimited, so that way it's free, free-ish, part of my monthly fee. Kindle Unlimited. So the way that I think I'm gonna fill out this, I would like to use our, like we have our Daily Grind highlighters, that's what I have in here. And I was just gonna do different colors for those and maybe write out what I have read. Yeah, like what I have read and what I would like to read. Let's do that. Okay, so I filled out few. I'm gonna keep going. I just don't wanna put, well, maybe I should. All the books I've read so far this year. It's kind of just what I'm doing with my bookshelf. And then as I read more, I'll keep, like, it's kind of like an incentive to just keep filling it out. No, I don't want to be negative and put the ones that I didn't like, but maybe I should include all of them. And then what you can do is for keys and color, like whatever you're coloring it, you could maybe do, that could be like your rating, or it's totally up to you. Like whatever, maybe like the type of book, completely up to you. And then there's a spot for notes up here. So I put Verity right at the top, Perfect Marriage, Housemaid. That's maybe what I'll do, like by color of like the ones that I really, really liked. That I put as Verity would be like favorite book of all time, and then after that I have like really, really good book, and then I have like right up there, and then after that it's like didn't like.
I'm doing not at all.
This can literally be whatever you want.
Meh, amazing, like the top, fave, and then good.
So it's like a generic rating of what I would say there. So on the like no, like hard no of not at all would be you shouldn't have come here. And this is just personal. I really didn't like any characters. So choosing something to read. I think this is gonna help me so much. I just looked through this, like we called it a bingo sheet, and there's basically prompts. So you can create your own challenge if you want to. This one, I'm going through it and I'm just reading it. I'm like, this is gonna help so much. So I went through on my Kindle, you can go through on Amazon and order some books or go to a local bookstore or to a library. One thing that I think is gonna help me is this one says, read a book that is under 200 pages. So there's two options for this. I'm fairly certain that is it the prequel or the sequel? The next Mrs. Parrish. I think that that's a shorter book. I think the other option that I know is under 200 pages is there was the last chapter written for Verity and I haven't read it. And I think that would get me out of my slump. So I'm legit excited about that. So what I'm gonna do is as I'm looking at the bingo and I'll cross things off when I add it to my 4-month TBR. So I'm gonna fill out my TBR list, which is your to be read. This little arrow explaining that. Start month, I will write that down. We are headed into April, and I'm gonna put you can just write down the titles, or you can do like a little print off from your computer or get one of these little photo printers. So one thing I will say, that photo printer is not amazing. I used another one. I have a different one in Canada, much better, because you can actually like peel and stick the photo paper. It prints it in one shot. This one kind of does like multiple layers. It still does a good job. So I kind of estimated how big they were. I tried to measure, I estimated pretty well. So I'm gonna cut these. And again, like is there a peel and stick? Oh, so I'm gonna show you how I'm doing this, but how you can do this if you don't feel like doing this. Again, you can just write the title, you can color in the square. You can also just print it on like black and white paper, like a regular printer, and just print it to size. So I had measured them. They're about 3.5 by 2.5 centimeters. And it doesn't matter if you go over the lines either. I just think with the color, it's very pretty. What I did is I went through the bingo, like the challenge, and I grabbed two books that I know are pretty short for me to read to at least get me back into it. It's a little tiny book.
And then I have these little, so like glue tape is what it's called. And then the Verity book by Colleen Hoover, which is like one of my favorite books of all time. I never read that final chapter that she released with like the explanation. I'm guessing the explanation. Exclusive new chapter. So I know that that's under 200 pages, which is one of the prompts. So I think I'm going to dive back in with that. And then I found these, so the way that I found these two books as like suggestions, went on to Amazon. We're really close up. Went on to Amazon and I searched Verity, the book, like the original. Purchased July 9th, 2022. And then I scrolled all the way down and then there was suggestions of similar books. So there's Too Late by Colleen Hoover, which was already on my list. And then it said similar books based on genre. So one of the first books that came up that was similar was Ask Andrea, and I've never heard of that. And then I read the description, I was like, yes. Silent Patient I read, Housemaid I read, Perfect Marriage I read, Funny. They're like all my favorite books. Run on Red, that was a different one, I didn't read that one. So there was these two, like I said, that were suggested. So that's where I came up with them. So Too Late by Colleen Hoover and Ask Andrea by Noelle
W. Illy, I think is how I'd say her last name. Feel good to go. I'm gonna set up my weekly reading log. So today's Monday, I'm filming this on a Monday. We are officially set up. I'm gonna put that away. My little titles printed here, stuck on. I'm ready to rock and roll. I downloaded Ask for Andrea, and The Next Mrs. Parrish isn't out yet. I thought it was. I thought it was just an extra chapter. And then the Colleen Hoover one, I don't think you can read it on Kindle, so I'm gonna either order it or go to a bookstore. I could probably sit on the floor of a Barnes & Noble and just finish it in one sitting, I'm guessing, because I read the rest of the book. I would consider rereading it, though. It's that good. Like, I really liked it. And by the way, don't believe everything you read online, because I just Googled Verity. It just shows. There's Eeyores everywhere. I Googled Verity, and someone on, like, some random blog was like,
I don't like it. It's the worst book ever.
It's the best book ever. It's incredible. So Colleen Hoover, you're a rock star, and I think you're great. And Eeyore can stay under their dark cloud. Yay. Okay, I feel very well set up. So this is my little reading tracker set up. We're good to go. Everything will be launching on the Daily Grind website. These are already available, the Luxe Collection. The reading tracker insert will be launching on Wednesday, the 27th at 3 p.m. Eastern. And it is the beginning of a few launches. So I'm really excited. I hope you guys enjoyed this little plan with me. I will link the, I won't link the printer I use because I don't think it's that good. I'll link the printer that I love that I have at home. I believe it's by Canon. Far superior, it's not our product, love it. The highlighters that I used were perfect because they're like little pastel colors and very easy to color with. So I will link all of these things. And usually they're like in the shop below the video too. So I hope you guys enjoyed. And happy reading. If you have suggestions for me on something that I must read that fits the category of crazy lady, I'm all ears, and I will see you guys very soon. Bye guys.